Hi there and welcome to Exult Tech. You might think that writing a C program without a semicolon is just like riding a cycle without pedals, but it is not like that. When we consider languages like Python, we may need not use semicolon to terminate a statement. Rather than semicolon, entering a new line character, nothing but pressing the enter button will automatically terminate that statement. So this is a simple Python program to print a string. I'm pressing the enter button to terminate that statement and that's it. But when it comes to languages like C, C++ and Java, you may need to use semicolon everywhere to terminate a statement. So here is how to avoid using semicolon in a C program to print a string. So the first method is by using the hash define preprocessor. So in the hash define preprocessor, I have to include the word hash define followed by space and a valid C identifier with which the semicolon is to be replaced and followed by the replacement list semicolon. So I have replaced the semicolon character with the C identifier named fun. So as usual, let us write the main function. And inside the main function, let me just print a string. So usually in this situation, we will be using a semicolon to terminate this printf statement. But instead of that, now we are going to use that C identifier with which we replace the semicolon using the hash define preprocessor. So internally during the compilation, automatically the word fun will be replaced by a semicolon in the object code, but it won't change anything in the source code. So let us compile and run this program. Let us see what happens. Yeah, I haven't used semicolon over there, but using hash defined preprocessor, it automatically replaced the word fun with semicolon, as a result of which the output was generated without any errors. So this is the first method. Actually, in this method, I am using semicolon in this place. So in order to avoid this also, we can use another method, that is by using conditional statements. That's nothing but if statements. So I am writing the main function. Normally we would write the print function like this and terminate it by a semicolon. So instead of doing this, we can include this print statement within an if condition like this. So this will not generate any errors because printf statement generally returns the total number of characters entered inside it as a parameter, and automatically it won't create any errors in our program. And including the printf inside a if condition will avoid using semicolon in it. Will this program generate the output without any errors? Let's see. Let me run the program. Yeah, we've got it. So similarly, we can use if else statements and switch cases, etc. to avoid using semicolon in this type of programs. So thanks for watching. Subscribe Exult Tech. See you in the next video soon. Bye.